Hi, I'm Ryan.
And I'm Kevin.
And we're from the Neville Public Museum. Today we're going to show you some artifacts that are in our collection here at the museum that are not normally on display, like some of the things you see around us here. They're up in our collection storage area. And the thing that all these artifacts have in common is that they've been replaced by one single object. Today, many people carry these artifacts, which are from the last 150 years, around in their pocket in the form of one single phone. So that's what we're going to look at today. Items from our museum collection that have been replaced by the cell phone.
So speaking of telephones, Ryan, what is this one?
All right, so this is a phone that was manufactured by a company called the American Electric Company. And they made a lot of different phones. The company started in the 1880s. This phone, though, is probably from the 1950s or 60s. Probably was used in an office or something like that. And this phone actually is what we call a rotary phone. It looks a little bit different than the phones that you've probably used before. The company American Electric was a pretty big phone maker for a long time, but by the 1980s, their company had kind of fallen out of favor and was replaced by other phones. So, Kevin, do you know how this rotary phone works?
Well, I used to have one of these in my house when I was growing up. Yes, it's not that long ago that they went out of favor or out of, fashion even, as technology advanced. But yeah, I mean, as you can see here, it's interesting about telephones. Well, first of all, this is much later in time, but the first telephones, you can go back to the late 1600s. And in fact, if you think about it, it was really two tin cans with a string between them. People would listen that way. But we can credit Alexander Graham Bell, the great Scottish inventor. And it was March 10th of 1876, where the first telephone call was ever made, actually, in Massachusetts. Said Alexander, of course he was Scottish, he gets on the phone and his assistant is there on the other line, he cranks it, he says,
"Mr. Watson, come here, I want you."
And from there, it changed the world. The way we actually communicate, it was a watershed moment, and patents were taken out after that, many of them. And then, actually, it was only 6 years later, in 1882, that the first phones were installed in Green Bay, Wisconsin. So, in fact, it was Henry Hagemeister, who was a big beer baron, and he had an office at his house, and he had a phone connecting the two of those together. So, nowadays, we have thousands and thousands of phone lines. And of course, things are changing. But this phone in particular, from the mid 20th century in this case, many, many years after that first Alexander Graham Bell phone call was made, this was at about time when there were about 40,000 telephones in Green Bay. So these would have been used where you'd have, in this case, you could dial zero for the operator and it would patch you through to the operator. Or in this case, when this was used, there were probably only four or five digits that you would have to dial, in this case, rotate to get to the number that you were trying to call.
Excellent. Yeah, what I thought was really interesting is the dialing function, what that really does is it creates a tone that the phone then uses to connect to the right number. It used to be that you would just pick up your old phone line and it would connect to an operator, and they would physically have to take a plug out of one socket, put it into a different socket in order to connect you to the person you wanted to talk to. This phone, though, sent a series of different sounds to the phone company, and it kind of electrified or automated that process. And then, of course, later modern day phones that you might even have today, you just push a button. So instead of having to dial all those numbers, you just push the buttons that you want. And that was a technology that took quite a while to come into fashion. That didn't really overtake the rotary phone until about the 1980s or the 1990s. So when Kevin and I said that we had these rotary phones in our houses when we were younger, I use it all the time. I remember calling my friends on the phone like this.
Well, you have to remember numbers nowadays. You don't even have to. Your phone is all there with your phone book in it. But back then, you'd have to go to a phone book and try to find their numbers too. So things have changed. Things have gotten smaller, but of course, a lot more efficient in how we communicate. So what's very interesting, of course, times have changed, and people watching this video probably never use these anyway. But today, the landline is really kind of a thing of the past. Most people in Brown County, and in fact in North America, have something like this, the mobile phone, the cell phone, that's mobile, it'll take you with you. You don't have to be at your house or wherever that phone line is. So things are changing more and more, where in fact most people probably don't even have a landline anymore. I know I don't in our house in Green Bay here. I use just this cell phone that has everything I need in it, as well as my wife, and people know how to get a hold of us that way.
Yep, I looked up the statistic. Over 50% of the people now don't have a phone connected to their house, so they're just using their cell phones. And of course, no need for anything like this for wires. Nowadays, the signal just travels through the air into cell phone towers instead of under or over power lines and other types of wires that the phone signal will go through.
Last fun fact about area code 920, that came into existence in 1997. So that's the region of Green Bay and this area of northeastern Wisconsin. So it's not that long ago. I graduated high school in 97, and that was the first time they're using that area code. So we'll see where it goes as more cell phones get out there and the need for getting a better signal. You might have to increase your area code coverage.